It's been an eventful 24 hours. Man, lots happened. A lot of information's been thrown out there in the past 24 hours involving Oklahoma, Texas, and the SEC. Lot of misinformation out there too. It's kind of the world we live in today. Sometimes you just don't know who to trust, but you gotta take a step back and filter out all the craziness and, talk to the people, listen to the people you trust. So, as the dust is about to settle, because there's another bomb that's going to go off when this actually becomes official, and don't misunderstand. As I'm recording this, I'm believing more and more this is happening. This is going to happen, and it's going to happen a lot sooner than you think, no pun intended. So, the one constant in all of this is Texas A&M. You see a lot of their fanboys out there, some who run message boards, who are posturing and taking, cheap shots and, want to talk about the type of shirts that Lincoln Riley wears and think like that's an insult. And what it tells me, and a lot of the Aggies, my favorite one, by the way, was the post on TexAggs about how please call your local Texas governor and lieutenant governor and House of Representatives and senators. We got to get on the phone call and block this from happening. It is the most pathetic thing I think I have ever seen from any member of any fan base, not involving committing a crime. But then again, this is Texas A&M. And as I said yesterday, the one thing A&M would always float and have that one little advantage they claim to have over OU and Texas or anyone else recruiting high caliber players they're going after, that little SEC logo on their jersey. But you ain't gonna have that much longer, are you? That's gone now. Because the two big boys that bullied you for years, we're coming home. So, with that being said, how's this gonna go down? Number one, let's clear up this one little piece of info. Stop with the Oklahoma legislators won't allow OU and Oklahoma State to break up or not be in the same conference. That's a bunch of crap. That's a bunch of crap. Like I've heard that for Florida, bunch of states who say, "Oh, the legislator won't let that happen." No, nobody has that kind of power. So stop with that. It's all made up. It's just posturing by people saying, "Oh, they want to." The governor's getting involved. It's just a cute thing to say when a story leaks and whenever realignment comes up over the course of however many years. Oh, they will never let this happen. Guess what? This is happening. This is definitely happening. If I were you, I'd get prepared. But here's the thing that I take away from this with Texas A&M. Word is leaking out, and people are saying, "Oh, Missouri's a hard no, and A&M's a hard no, and these other schools like LSU and Georgia or Florida, they'd be a hard no or whatever." It's like, you know what I'm hearing? There's only one hard no, and that's Texas A&M. Rest of the league, they're inviting us on in. They ain't scared. And you know what? Good for them. Because, I heard about the SECs. They go, "Come, you wouldn't survive an SEC conference schedule, this and this and that." Well, guess what? We're about to find out. And you know what? Props to the rest of the SEC who ain't scared. They're like, "Come on in, Oklahoma, Texas. You think you can take us on?" I was like, "I gladly accept the challenge." As I'm sure Texas fans do. I think we'll have a lot of fun. Aggies ain't gonna have a lot of fun. I am going, I pray that in a few weeks, when this gets announced, I pray they say with a 13-to-1 vote, Oklahoma and Texas will join the SEC in 2023 or 2024, or whenever it's gonna happen. I hope that happens. But you never know. They can get strong arm into voting yes. Little things can be, talked about, maybe, little favors under the table or threatening them. Because you have to ask yourself, if they're gonna be that much of a problem, do we need you? Because we got Texas and Oklahoma now. Do we really need A&M? I don't think that's gonna go that far, mind you, but that's why they're scared. A&M knows what's going to happen when we join the conference. It's over. Their window of opportunity is about to close. And they know if they don't do something like now, like this year, next year, year after that, they never win it. They ain't never going to win because all those advantages they have with recruiting and the TV exposure and all that, they're gone now. All gone. So I hope you've enjoyed it while it's lasted. I mean, you start off strong with Johnny Manziel and everything. You came close. You almost made the SEC championship game that one time, but another Crimson powerhouse got in your way. And guess what? Another one's about to come up from behind and beat your ass, too. Just like the old days, Aggies? Oh, I can't wait. It's going to be fun. It is going to be fun. So, a lot of other stuff out there. But yeah, I just want to clear that up. Like, the whole legislature thing, not buying it for a second. It's like that's not going to mean anything. Oh, you can't leave Oklahoma State. There'll be some people who scream on Twitter or television or whatever, but at the end of the day, we might still play Oklahoma State non-conference. Georgia plays Georgia Tech non-conference. South Carolina plays Clemson non-conference. Florida State play non-conference. They're all in-state rivals. Kentucky, Louisville. It's not like we can't do it too. I don't know where the Pokes will end up. Maybe the Pac-12 or AAC or the MAC. Who knows? But, they ain't coming. Personally, I would trade Missouri for the Pokes just for fun, but it's not my decision. And I know why Missouri is where they're at. So Missouri wanted to be a Big Ten team anyway, but they couldn't get that. That's where we're at. Just like 24 hours later, everything's gone insane. A lot of rumors, a lot of speculation, but the more I hear as of now, it's 13-1 in OU Texas' favor of being invited in. This does not happen. This story doesn't leak. It doesn't get this far unless it's imminent. That's the way I feel about it. People are not freaking out. Fans, talking heads, journalists, whatever. It doesn't get this far unless it's imminent. So that being said, got a few weeks. We got 6 weeks till the season. But who knows what's going to happen in a few weeks. This is going to get all the attention. All of it. And, maybe a couple years wait. We'll have our last song and dance with the Big 12. But a lot of dominoes are going to fall. And West Virginia, who knows where they end up? Kansas, where are they going to end up? Because I don't think the Big 12 is surviving. You do the last thing you want to do is become like the old Big East and become what the American is. Now, the Americans built themselves up nicely, but that's not what you want to become because you lose that Power 5. So it's going to be a Power 4 at the end of the day. And we're going to super conferences. It's coming. Domino's going to fall. See where teams end up. But right now, everyone get your NCAA 14 out, make your custom conferences, and have some fun with it because a couple years, that's what the SEC is going to look like. And we'll talk later about, OU fan etiquette in a new conference with the SEC and how we should handle ourselves. No SEC chants. That's not what we do. We are not going to shout the name of our league because we have enough to be proud of ourselves. Remember that, guys. Remember that. So, Aggies, we coming. We know you scared. You're very scared. And I can't wait to see the look on your face when we walk into Kyle Field down the road and beat you by 30. It's going to be great. You all have a good one, Boomer Sooner, and see y'all later.